Hello guys, it's Franco here, and today I wanted to show you how to play Isabella from Jimi Hendrix. And today, this video, I will show you just the intro. I start with saying that this song starts with an intro in D position, and later the song is going on G, K, and it does G, C, and later it's going D's. F any going back, and like that is going the song. But today I'm going to show you first the intro, all right? And it's not really important what you want to use, that's all personal, but what you, if you want a strat, a fart, six drives, that's all matter to you. I use not Univibe, but this song has a beautiful Univibe tone. And when I was playing this song, me too, I used the Univibe, but I never set the Univibe on one position. I was playing the song, I was rocking it like a wah pedal back in the day. And nothing amusing, man. Yes, sir. And already later, any of you is going to ask, how are the settings? Those are not important. That's all about you. If you like it, keep it. But my settings are all the equalization at 10, alright? Resonance and presence is at 2. I go on the crunch channel. Gain at 4, and volume is at 3, and it's already loud here. Plus I'm using an MKF drive on the top of it. And that's my tone. And I'm rolling down the volume of the guitar, because I don't need all that aggressivity, until the point I will do the solo. So that's it. So my guitar is tuned up, step down, and let's start with the minor pentatonic in D position. So on the 10th fret. The rhythm of this song is beautiful, alright? So what I'm doing is always keep my thumb on the root note of D, this finger on the other D, so without determining if my chord is minor or major chord. So, and I'm doing something like, I'm improvising the song, so I never played two times in the same time Hendrix songs, and I never copied point to point. I'm just giving the input and trying to play the song without copying note after note. So if you feeling like you want to change something, feel free to do it. That's your way to play it. What is important is that you are giving the input of the song. So basically here, by maintaining this kind of rhythmic, I'm hitting this note, and later I'm doing the bending here. So. And always maintaining my root note there. So next one is, so and here I'm pressing even that, so but with this finger, so both of them together, so is so the first one is based on Second one is. But with this finger. Try to divide them, alright? And practice much more on the rhythmic. Remember, all the other notes are muted by my hand. That come naturally with time. And you know, I'm not really a kind of teacher, so. And let's do it again. First. Now. Always. Maintain your timing, moving. That's very important. Music is done in the time, so you must have timing. Alright, that's really important. And another thing is what it helps us guitarists, okay? Many guitarists, as soon they are hearing reading and bright music, they are going to panic. But I suggest you, if you never did, start to do it, because it's very important and it's opening for you another world and you're going to be much more completed. I learned when I was little, thanks to my mom, she learned me how to write and read music. So anytime we were playing this song, okay, I remember, later I will show you, for what, for me, learn how to read and write music, it was really important. So the first part, as I said to you, is based on this note, this note, this note, this note, this note. Second one on. I will show you again. Now, it's going on the high 3 string, always on the D pentatonic. And he does this. I know. He's, wow, what did he? What did he? Basically, he's those two, this. You know, you are bending them. Hope it's not too loud later on the video. But again, it's a combo of notes. So again, and 1 and 2, 1 and 2, and you can invert them, you can do them in this sequence, you can add your own, and I will show you. This song, that's Hendrix, that's why it's beautiful playing Jimi Hendrix songs, because anytime it's like you're feeling free to add your stuff, you know, not like Pink Floyd songs that if you're touching them they start to smell. You supposed to don't touch Hendrix, Pink Floyd songs, especially solo, but on Hendrix, especially rhythmic parts, they are beautiful. So let's do this song again from the beginning, like again, so. Hendrix here, he does something like. He's going. They were going. And now I'll explain to you why it's important to read and write music. When I was playing this song in my band, right, I had Pepe on the drum, brilliant drummer, and I had O Vincenzo o Pasquale on the bass. We were three of us, and you know, when you're going to play, happen that maybe you drink some beer or smoke it, or you want to impress someone. So instead, to make this riff always the same, sometimes you would make it shorter, or because you want to impress the girl that you are going to make it longer. So the question was, when we are going to start this song? So came the drummer, he said, Franco, let's do like that. Give us a sign, and in 2 bars of 440, we are going, all of us, on the root note, inside the song. What does it mean? 2 bars of 440 is 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. On that 4, all of us, we're supposed to be here. You know the song? So, 2, 3, 4, are supposed to hit that. And I had the this chord. That's a D9 chord, like you can hear even on. But on D. Okay? So, 2 bars, and I did something like we were doing. Drummer, ta ta, all together, tu do ru tu. And that was 2 bars of 440. So. And all of us were inside the song in the time, and it was a kind of explosion. Because wow, they entered there. Beautiful, while Hendrix, with his band of gypsy, they were brilliant. I think Hendrix just looked at them and said, let's go it. Because on here he's entering even the bass. So that was the intro, and that's how I'm playing the intro. I will show you again, from the beginning. Remember the note here? And later as the combo between all of that by doing and you wanna this intro last, I don't know, 2 minutes, do it, 1 hour, do it. If you're playing with the band, create your trick. Oh, my trick was this one, I will show you. So hold the song. Like that we were entering. So again from the beginning. All on D minor pentatonic. The first two are. If you are grabbing all the notes, it is alright. With time you're gonna understand it, and with time you're gonna sound better and better. More you're practicing, more is coming up. And especially if you are using, I don't know, a nice fuzz pedal with a Univibe. I was rocking my Univibe with feet like this anytime I was doing this song with time. And it was sounding great. So. Second part. Bassist and drummer, one of them, you know, looking, Franco, come on, let's do it. And like that we were doing it. Hope it's clear, hope I didn't mess your thoughts up. I'm not a teacher, absolutely I'm not one for teaching you. I'm learning, I learned by myself, and I know how to write read music. From I think I will do some lesson about it in the future, because it's really important. That's my own way to play this song. I'm never playing this song 2 times the same, and anytime I'm adding or I'm not adding, doing it longer, not longer, especially the intro. The song itself has that structure that you must to respect. I will show you later how to play completely this song. So for now that was just the intro, and I hope it's going to help you. It's not important what you're using, absolutely. And let's do one time again. So I will do all the intro, going there, and stop the song. Because later I will show you how to play the full song. Hope it's going to work. See ya guys.